Hi, I'm Rabbi Robyn from Manchester Reform Synagogue, here to just do a short reflection on the festival of Purim. I think it's fair to say I've had quite a complicated relationship with Purim over the years. It used to be one of my least favourite festivals. I found it very hard to let go, to enjoy the joy of the festival in the month of Adar. When Adar comes in, the sages say joy increases. But I found it very difficult to let go, whether that's my British sensibility or something else. Being silly, carefree, feels like an anathema to me sometimes. Very serious in the world of capitalism, where it's about productivity, not about, you know, getting to our human need of joy. For me, letting go is really hard. I like to be in control. And Purim is the opposite. It's a turned upside down world. The story of Esther, it's a carnival, masks are worn, everything is back to front. We don't know what's real and what isn't. And it's chaotic, it's uncertain. And that can be terrifying. But over the years, especially in the last couple of years, I have looked forward to Purim more and more. And at this time, when Purim is happening whilst we're still in lockdown, I actually need it more than ever. One, because I think we all need a release, a way of letting go of some of the stress and the generalised anxiety of being a human in this world at the moment. Purim is going to give me a chance to get dressed up, to laugh, to be silly, and to just release some of the things that I've been holding, as we all have as well. I think Purim also has such a powerful message for us. Not only does it show us what it is to be humans, the ups and the downs of being human, the violence that we are capable of, the intrigue, you know, going behind people's backs, being deceitful, all of those things. It also shows us the bravery. Really within one story, we have the whole gamut of human experience and characteristics. And it's always so helpful to see that mirrored back to us. My teacher at seminary, Dr. Jeremy Schoenfield, talked about the development from Purim to Pesach, to Passover, of being kind of going from a childlike state to going to an adult state. That Purim is what we do when we're hurt and wounded, when we're being childlike, full of joy, living in the moment, acting crazy, and retaliating. You know, the massacre at the end of the book, chapter 9, you know, if we're given the power, we then have power over, we don't go to power with, but we're caught in a cycle of oppression. It's a very childlike circle. But when we get to Passover, we've developed, we've got somewhere, we're towards freedom. And how remarkable that feels this year, if we think about the potentially getting out of lockdown over this time period. But we get to a moment of freedom. And instead of celebrating and then enacting violence on others after we've been released from our violence, at Passover we're told, don't rejoice at the death of the Egyptians at the Red Sea. That's not for you to rejoice. Rejoice about your freedom, but not their death. What a different way of responding. We sit down, we have a seder, we have a meal, we have an order. Seder, the word means order. It's completely different to Purim. But we need both. Both of those work as mirrors for us together. To find moments of joy alongside the sorrow, to work on our own spiritual and collective redemption and working towards freedom. So I hope that whether you're celebrating Purim or not, the month of Adar brings you some way of being able to release and is the roadmap for you to be towards spiritual and personal development.